Hi everyone, my name is Sandra. Welcome back to my channel. Today's makeup look is using the Anastasia Beverly Hills and Jackie Aina palette. It is a fall look, and if you'd like to see how I got it, keep on watching. Hi, so everyone. I'm really excited for today's look. Number one, I have a lot to say. Number two, this video is all about the Jackie Aina palette. Once again, it is almost a year later, and I have realized how much I love this palette. As you guys know, the last few video looks, I've been releasing makeup and eye looks. They're really dark because usually when you think of fall, it's like the orange, the kind of dark reds, the dark browns. And this time I've been wanting to do like dark navy blue, dark forest green, like just like the dark, rich, deep colors. And there's no other palette that I love more for that than this one. Like these shadows are beautiful. The only thing that is a little hard for lighter skinned gals or guys is that the crease shade is pretty dark to start out with, but we're gonna make it work and we're gonna just start with this palette. And despite that it is an Anastasia Beverly Hills Jackie Aina eye look, most of the face products I'll be using today are by Tarte, because I realize I haven't used my Tarte products in a while, and I really want to kind of start that again. So I'm going to start with my makeup and then we're going to get talking. It's kind of going to be a get ready with me. I don't have anywhere to go. Honestly, I need to wash my hair. So I'm going to do my makeup and then I'm going to go wash it off, which is crazy. But I really wanted to get this video and eye look for you guys, because I realized that I better get cracking on those fall looks, because before we know it, Christmas is going to be here and we need to do some kind of holiday festive looks. So I'm going to start by priming my skin. I am moisturized already, but I feel like, especially with it being winter, the cold, the dry air just zaps some moisture right out of your skin. And here in Alberta, it's been, well, where I live in Edmonton, it's been really windy lately, like kind of breezy every day. So it just kind of, even though the days have been like 20 plus, the nights are like zero. And it just, it's so, such a really, like, that's a pretty big temperature change, really. And my skin is really dry. So I'm going to start with my base tape. And I always say this about every product that I use, but I always forget how much I love a product until I start using it again. Like, how many of you guys do that? And I guess, honestly, like, for the most part, like, people who only have, like, a couple of foundations, like your summer and your winter, or only a few products, probably don't, like, you use your stuff every day. But for someone who has a really large collection, you only get to certain products every now and then. How do you feel about your products? Like, are you like, oh, I miss this, I need to start using this again? Or you're like, oh, I haven't used it in so long, I'm just gonna chuck it. Sometimes I get like that, but every year I go through my makeup collection and I just decide what I'm gonna get rid of, what I haven't been liking or using lately. So that's kind of what I do. So I'm going to use my Tarte face tape. This is Double Duty Beauty face tape, the shade 35N medium neutral. I usually go for the golden, I think it's medium golden, which is my better shade color, but this one's going to be toast pretty soon. So we're going to use this one instead. I'm also using my Real Techniques Miracle Face Complexion Sponge because it's really, really damp, and I'm kind of going for more of a matte finish. I always forget how much I love using the sponge. And so this is kind of what I wanted to talk about. So when I first started doing my makeup, like really getting back into full-blown, you know, full glam looks, that was 2 years ago already, you guys. Like, that is crazy. So February of this year was a year that I've been on YouTube, and I wanted to do my YouTube channel before February. I started February 15th, I believe, was my first post. And yeah, I wanted to post before, but I was like nervous. I was scared, of course. And I didn't want to put my life out there because I didn't want to be judged. And now, after kind of realizing what, you know, people can be cruel online too, because you don't have to see anyone to their face. So it's easier to like say what you want to say online, I think. But I was worried about being judged and about what people would think of me. And I thought, like, once I had my kids, I thought I was over that. I'm like, ugh, I don't really care what people think. But to an extent, I think we all care what people think. And it's always nice to get praise for something that we've done good, something that we enjoy doing, and that we've done well, because it shows that you care about, what it is that you're doing. So that's kind of why I waited so long, because I think I started building up my makeup collection. And I've said this before. Before, really, at that point in my life, I didn't believe in going to Sephora. As crazy as that sounds, because you guys know how much I love my hauls now. But I was like, there's no way in hell I'm spending like that kind of money on makeup. So here I am kicking myself in the mouth because I go to Sephora quite often and I love getting expensive makeup. And so I started kind of building up my expensive makeup collection, mostly eyeshadow palettes, but it did eventually range to the face products and everything else except for eyeliners. And I think I started with my bullet journal actually. I remember posting my February bullet journal spread on Instagram because I wanted to know what kind of reaction I'd get. And then I got a few comments and it was so exciting. So that's kind of when I started. And I think the biggest realization for me wasn't so much I was scared of what people thought. I was like, if I start this, it's gonna be an ongoing thing, like a job, even though I don't get paid for it, but it's working for myself. So it wasn't as much pressure, but it was still pressure because, like, now you can't just stop. Like, I think one of my biggest pet peeves, and that there are some people that I follow that still do this, and I'm not gonna name names because I do really enjoy watching their channel, so I'm not gonna say anything about that, but my biggest pet peeve is when people say that they're gonna post like Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and then they end up posting one video a month. I can't stand that. I hate that. Drives me nuts. If you wanna take a break, by all means, that's okay. But as long as you tell your subscribers ahead of time, because it's disappointing when you're looking forward to one of your favorite YouTubers and then all of a sudden they stop posting. It's like, what the hell? Like, then why are you supporting them? So, yeah. Okay, we're gonna take a little break. I'm gonna do some concealer. I'm going to use my Tarte Shape Tape in light sand. It's gonna be a pretty bright look. I will contour because I've got my Tarte Park Ave Princess ready to go. And I'm gonna use so much makeup today just because I want to. You guys, normally I used to do this all the time and use so much makeup, and now I haven't been going as heavy like this, but I want to do, like, this is kind of how I did my makeup at Christmas time. When I do full glam looks, I love to pile it on, especially when there's lots of lights, and I like to make it sure it's set really well, so I use a lot of powder. So yeah, just let's not talk about the amount of makeup I'm using right now because I look ridiculous. But yeah, so that's one of my biggest pet peeves. So that was like kind of why I didn't really want to start, and I kept procrastinating it because I was like, yeah, I don't wanna have to, like, once I start, I'm never gonna stop. But then I realized when I did start how much I enjoy it. Like, it is so much fun to me. Not just to receive comments from you guys, because I do love interacting with anyone that enjoys my content and is watching my channel. Like, that's one of my favorite things to do. And speaking of, oh my gosh, you guys, I'm so busy this week. There's two comments that I have to respond to that are like, one's really old and then one is just fairly recent, but I haven't responded to it yet. And they're both like stationary questions, so I need to get that done. It's like one of those things that have been on my list for like the last month or two, and I just keep moving it forward. So, speaking of like being busy, I guess. This week isn't that bad. There are still some things I want to do. Like, pretty much because I have a 5-month-old. I've got my son. As kind of full disclosure, my son was sick this week. So, and it wasn't the virus or anything. I didn't get him tested, but it was just a cold. And like, I mean, I don't know. People will say, "Oh, you don't know that for sure," but the requirements with his specific school is that either you can get your kid tested to make sure, like, to rule it out, or and then they can be back after the 4 or 5 days or whenever you get results, or you can leave them home for 10 days. So now that they finally decided to do the throat swab instead of just the nasal swab, but I didn't want my kid to have to go through that. So I said, I'm just going to keep him home for the 10 days. And he'll be going back to school this week, so that's fine. And no one else has gotten sick, so I think it was just a cold. I've been doing pretty good at keeping everything sanitized and clean. And it is what it is. And it was just the sniffles, too. It's not even like a big deal. That's all he had. And it just sucks because I've been pretty stressed this week because I had to go over his school stuff with him. And I have no idea why I even thought I could do any homeschooling with him. Because at first I was like, I'm going to homeschool my kid. Yeah, never. My son is not the kind of kid that I could homeschool ever. He needs the interaction. He has to be with other kids. And he has to be taught by somebody else because he won't listen to me. And it's just really frustrating because there's expectations from the school, expectations from the teacher that you get this stuff done that you're following up with. And when your kid doesn't listen to you, what do you do? So super frustrating this week. I'm just going to set my eyes area, or actually my entire face, with my Cody Airspun. I haven't used this forever either. And I did open up my new one. So my old one is now gone. And I really, I miss using this. It just makes my face look so matte. And that's one of my favorite things in fall and winter for makeup is like a matte face. Okay, so continuing on with like the discussion of the day, it's been busy this week, but at the same time, like my daughter, like today for instance, my daughter has not slept, and it's Sunday. Chad still works, so it's not really like any different than any other day. Oh, I need new brushes. I needed to get my other Sigma brushes because I realize I'm powdering and I need my large powder brush. I feel like I have no room for anything. Oh my god. Okay. Oops. Okay. Hashtag first world problems. Alright. She didn't sleep at all today. And it's really frustrating because I literally couldn't get anything done. And I have so much on my plate right now. I've been staying up because I haven't had to get up at 6 o'clock to take my son to school. I've been staying up to like 1, 2 o'clock in the morning, getting some stuff done. And then I sleep in till about 8 o'clock every day, 8, 9 o'clock. And I haven't been getting the best sleep because my daughter's been getting up multiple times at night. And so yeah, it hasn't been the best, but at least, I've been able to sleep in a little bit. So this is one of those days when I'm like gonna have to stay up again late tonight and do some stuff. The night before last, I got my November bullet journal spread set up, so I drew it out in pencil, and it's still not like 100% where I want it. I might want to change the font, but I just kind of penciled it in quickly just to kind of for placement and just to see what it looks like the way it is. And I don't think I'm 100% happy with it, but I got that done. I'm currently working on a custom bullet journal, and we'll see how that goes because I've got some part penciled in. I'm done the first month so far, but I still have to go in and outline it with a fine liner and then color it in. So it's going to be a lot of work. And next week, is it next week already or the week after? I think it's next week. It's going to be super, super busy. So next week and pretty much the week after. I think maybe the week after. Yeah, because if I plan this week, I'll be doing my plan with me on Friday. So it'll be the Monday. What day is that? Thanksgiving week? Yes, Thanksgiving week is going to be so hectic and so crazy. So if you guys are interested in looking at a hectic, crazy, busy planning week, that will be posted on next Sunday. So today is Sunday, but today was my the purple theme, I would call it, with the washi tape with the little girls on it. And I love that one. Like, I love how the colors kind of match, but next one is going to be super, super busy because I'm going to be doing Thanksgiving dinner and I'm just inviting a few family members over for dinner, and that's pretty much it. We're also going to be going to Red Deer the following weekend, so it's going to be huge, busy, busy. And then when Chad's off, we're going to go into date night in the middle of the week while my son is in school. Yeah, I don't know who thought that one up, but it's the way his shift went. And if we're going to be in Red Deer for the weekend, we can't have a date night. Technically, it's time away, but it's not like just him and me time, so we're going to do that. And yeah, it's going to be a whirlwind week. It's going to be crazy, and I need to plan because Thanksgiving dinner, I'm going to have to plan out like my recipes and what I want to buy, when I'm going to buy it, when I'm going to cook it, etc., etc. So I'll talk about all of that kind of stuff when I'm doing my plan with me. So for now, I'm going to go ahead and do eyebrows. I think we'll just skip this part because I just want to skip it because it does take a long time and we just want to get through this as quick as possible. I did decide to use my Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz today. This is medium brown, only because my Urban Decay brow blade doesn't have this spoolie on the end, and it's like the most convenient to use this one. I always brush my eyebrows up, and I'm not sure if you guys will recall one of my last makeup looks, I did trim my eyebrows, and they're already bushy again. Like, that's pretty long for an eyebrow. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get this done, and we'll be right back. I did use the Anastasia Dip Brow Gel on top in medium brown as well, just to kind of set the hairs down in place. Normally, I would use the clear brow gel, but I don't have any on hand right now. And next, we're going to contour the face. So I'm using my Tarte Park Ave Princess. This has been like one of my favorites right from the beginning of makeup. When I found the Park Ave Princess Vault, I was in love. And then this is one of the products I've kept. The other ones I didn't really care for as much, but this one is my favorite. So I'm going to use my F40 Large Angled Contour. And I'm just going to go into Princess Cut and Angle. They're the two that are not sparkly. These two in the middle here. I don't really like sparkle when I do my contour. I feel like I haven't done this in such a long time. Like a nice deep contour and some like contouring around the face. I used to do this all the time, like especially when I'd have date night at our karaoke place. And since karaoke, and well, I guess basically since my daughter came, we stopped going to karaoke. I stopped going probably about 2 months or 3 months before she was actually born because I was pregnant and I didn't feel like going. And now I just miss it so much. So in any of these full glam looks, I love to contour my nose, I love to contour my cheeks, and I just like a really deep contour, especially when you're out and the lighting is a little bit darker. It's nice to be a little bit more dramatic in the harsh light of day, the harsh light of day, natural light, or even when there's bright lights, it doesn't look so good. But when we go out for karaoke or date night, like the place we go to is called Franco's, and it looks good at nighttime. Okay, so I'm just gonna go back in with my large powder brush and go over all of the areas that I've contoured here, just so it doesn't look really unblended. And then we're going to put some blush on. So I've decided to go for this Tartelette blush book. I haven't used this in forever, and the colors are so pretty. I'm going to use these two down here. So the shades are called Lilas and Secret Crush. And usually I actually maybe I will do these two instead because it's a bit more neutral instead of so pink. Steady Sesh and Team Spirit. So I use my F10 powder blush brush. And done. So I don't put too terribly much on. And I'm also going to go ahead and do highlight right now just because I can. We'll keep this out to do inner corner after. So I'm using my Tarte Skin Twinkle Volume 2. Apparently I can't talk today. So I will use, blah, 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 where are you? My F03 High Cheekbone Highlighter Brush. And I'm going to use the Spotlight shade, which is the darker one here. Because I find when my skin is blushed and just looking a little bit darker, the brighter one just looks like a white blinding highlight and it doesn't look so natural. This stuff smells good too. It smells like my Tarte Park Ave Princess palette. It smells like kind of fake chocolate. I don't know if that's good or bad. It smells good. But. Okay, so all of the high points of my face are highlighted. And then, oh, it's almost time for shadow. I'm so excited. I'm going to put some primer on. I'm using my Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion, the Anti-Aging Formula. I don't know if I like this one as much as the original. I think I used to have the original one a long time ago. And then I was like, I don't need eyeshadow primer. But you guys, it is so helpful and it does keep your shadow. Like honestly for me right now, if I'm just going to go wash it off, it's kind of pointless. But I'm trying to teach myself good habits. And you know, the more you do something, the more you'll tend to continue doing them. So, and also for you guys watching, any primer for your eyes, primer in general is always a good thing to do, good habit to get into using underneath your makeup for your face, and then specifically eye primer, super good for your shadow and it lasts for a long time. So next we're going to get right into the palette. So excited. I love this palette. I don't even know what I'm going to use, but I have my eye on this red color. I have my eye on the purple. I just don't know if that'll look good together. Another one is maybe the red and this one, the sponsored. I love this. Is my favorite shade in the entire palette. I haven't really used the pink one, but this would be a nice red look. But considering I did a red look with my Celestial Storm palette, kind of reddish brown, I'm going to try doing... Ooh, I haven't used Lituation either. That would be nice. Ooh. Ah, I don't know what to do. Okay, I'm going to start with ginger in the crease. Let's just start. We need like a starting point here. So we're going to do ginger in the crease. I'm going to tap off the brush. And like, I think it was supposed to rain today or tonight. And it's looking really cloudy and gross out right now. But like the temperature has seriously been... I'm just going to move in closer so you guys can see what I'm doing. The temperature has seriously been warm during the day. It just sucks at nighttime because it's like 0 to 2 around there. And I'm talking degrees Celsius. I'm not sure what that's in Fahrenheit. See, this looks pretty good. It's not overly dark. I am using an E35 just to do the beginning crease work. This is also like a good place to start off for your eye because you can kind of determine where your crease, like where you want your crease to be. So people with hooded eyes can kind of determine how far up you want your shadow, and the same thing with mine because mine are pretty deep set eyes, so I like to bring it up higher. I have a lot of space between like my crease and my eyebrow, so I have lots of room to play around with, and then I can kind of see where I want to go from there. I love this palette. I love the size of the Anastasia Beverly Hills palettes because they're small enough to pack, This is like the perfect, like when I go to Red here, I'll probably pack, I think my two favorite palettes right now out of my entire collection, even my Jeffree Star. And mind you, I love Blood Sugar, and I remember how much I wanted like Blue Blood when it first came out. I was in love with that palette. Then Blood Sugar, like those two, I love them. But out of my entire collection of eyeshadow palettes, I think my two favorites, this one and Anastasia Beverly Hills Soft Glam. I love that palette. I am so glad I got it. And now I kind of understand what the hype is about. Like, it's such a good palette for everyday wear, for going out. You can get some really nice looks out of that palette. Oh, and I really do like the Cor de Rosa by Sigma. And I'm thinking of getting the other palettes by Sigma as well. So I'll see. I don't, looking online, I'm not like, oh, I need those right now. But I mean, this is looking really nice. I don't want to do anything. I don't know if I want red or not. I'm so confused right now. What do I want to do? What do I want to do? If I do red on the lid, it's just gonna look. I'm gonna darken up the outside crease first. I'm gonna switch my brush. Gonna go in with an E25 now. I'm gonna go into edges. It's a little bit more of an orangey red. I'm gonna stick to the outer corner of my eye here, the outer crease, the outer corner, and build up color here. I can hear Connor downstairs practicing his words. I've been doing it every day so diligently, and if I don't catch him at the right time of day, he just flips out on me. It's so hard to try to teach him anything. It's like a concentration focus thing. But I don't know if he has ADHD or ADD. I don't know. It's hard to make a diagnosis with things like that because it's like, I don't know. I have an opinion about all of it. I'm gonna keep it to myself, but okay, so that looks good. I built up the color a little bit. Same brush, I'm gonna go into Credit, which is the darkest color in the palette. I'm just going to gently pat on my lid. And then putting this on the outside corner of my lid. Kind of building it up into the crease a tiny bit. I feel like I want to use the gold shades, but as soon as I do, I feel like they just, like it kind of takes away all of the other work that you've done on your eye. Like it just focuses on the gold. I like adding like this dark color to the outside lid because it really makes your eyes look further apart. Especially if you have close set eyes. Maybe one time I'll also do like a halo eye. I think I've done that before with this palette, but I mean, there's so many colors in here. You could just go crazy with whatever you want to do. I'm going to take a pencil brush now. This is an E30. I'm going to go into Credit and I'm going to drag this along the lower lash line, just kind of on the outside here, and connect it to the color on the top lid. I'll be kind of blending it out a little bit so it doesn't matter if it gets too big here. I'm going to take a flat definer brush. This is the E15. I'm going to dip it into Lituation, which is this kind of like sparkly gray purple smoky color. I'm going to try to apply it dry and see what it looks like. Popping this on the lower lash line, blending it into the dark brown. I think I like that color a lot. So I'm going to also add it to my lid. I'm going to use my finger first. I actually haven't used this shade and I don't know why not. Oh, it's so dark and so pretty. Love it. I love these dark eye looks, you guys. I'm in love with the darker look. I'm just going to take a brush and wipe away the fallout here. Okay, this is probably like my all-time favorite sparkly color. It's like purple, but not really purple. Oh, it's so dark. Okay, I'm gonna take now an E27. Wow, I was gonna say E25. I meant E27. I'm gonna go back into Lituation Dry, and I'm just gonna blow out the lower lash line. It looks good blown out when you've got like really nice soft edges. When it's just kind of like a harsh line like this, it doesn't look very good. I almost feel like I probably shouldn't have used edges because now it's like really red, warm brown up here. And then this color is like, feels like it should be more of a cool color. But I'm not too worried. I think it will look good with lashes. I'm not going to put lashes on today though. I'm just going to do mascara. Trying to think if there's another color that would look good with. I don't really want to add anything to the inner corner that's gold because it's just going to take away from the whole look. I like that purple color. But what I might do is take the E30 pencil brush again and go into Shookington, which is the bright purple sparkly shimmer shade, and just put some on the lower lash line in the middle here. So this is actually kind of going on the lower lash line and it makes it look like liner, but it's actually not liner. You have to be careful though, because if you have any problems with your eyes or you wear contacts, just be careful because you don't want it to bother you throughout the night. And I'm going to leave it as that. So if you see what I mean here, like it's pretty dark. I think if you wanted a lighter transition color, you'd have to dip into another palette because it's pretty dark. I'm going to add some color to the inner corner of my eye, some highlight, not color. And I'm going to use my teeny tiny detailed lip brush, my L04. I'm going to go into Daylight, which is this shade here. I like bringing it like right underneath the lower lash line, like kind of in a little bit to the color, because it just kind of brightens up your whole eye area. A little bit underneath the brow just for that lightness effect. And I'm not quite happy with the way this outer corner looks right here, so I'm just going to blend it out a teeny tiny bit. And I'm going to go ahead and line my lips, and then we'll do lipstick and then mascara. And I won't do mascara on camera because it just takes forever. But I'm lining my lips with my Milani Color Statement Lip Liner True Instant Color in 09 Spice. Okay, then I'm going to top that with my Tarte Lipsculptor Lipstick and Lip Gloss Duo. This is in the shade Adore. So I'm going to put the lipstick on first. I feel like I haven't worn lipstick in forever. I'm just patting this on. My lips have been pretty dry too lately. Then I will add some of the gloss on top. I'm just going to give my face a quick spray with my MAC Fix Plus. Ooh, feels so nice and refreshing. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do mascara and then I will show you guys the completed look. Okay guys, so that is it for this makeup look. So a couple of things. Number one, I was totally going to do a liquid line on my upper lash line and I forgot. I usually always do that when I do lashes, and because I didn't do lashes, I didn't do it. So, and doing it when you have lashes just kind of hides the lash band and makes it look really nice and neat, but it also makes your eyes look a little bit darker. And with these dark eye looks, I love to do that. So instead, I took some of my Morphe eyeliner. So instead what I did was I took some of my Morphe pencil colored liner in Dark Room, which is just the plain matte black, and I put some of my lower waterline and just made it darker that way. That was something I always used to do when I was in high school, junior high. I would love to line my eyes and just use tons of mascara, and that was pretty much my makeup routine back then. But I think it has changed quite dramatically in, you know, the last 20 or so years. So I hope you guys enjoyed this makeup look. If you did, please leave this video a thumbs up. Also, if you're new here, I'd love if you subscribed. And last but not least, don't forget to click the little bell button so you'll be notified every time I upload. We'll talk to you guys again very soon. Bye now.